contaminated soil. In the worst affected areas, the top half meter is being taken away and buried between town and remote parts of the Soviet Union. In the villages, workmen are clearing out the surface of the pavements and even removing asphalt from the roads. In a series of briefings for the British delegation, officials explained the steps that have been taken to meet the fears of the local population. When contamination was found on leaves of some trees in Kiev, all the leaves in the Soviet Union's third largest city were swept up last autumn and buried in special bags. It was hearing of measures like that which somehow seemed to throw doubt on the latest estimate for cancer deaths that are likely to arise from the accident. Anatoly Romanenko, director of the Soviet Radiological Institute and health minister for the Ukraine, said their latest research showed that the radiation dose on the local population had in fact been 15 times less than originally estimated. As a result, the forecast for additional cancer deaths in the Soviet Union over the next 40 years, resulting directly from the accident, was now put at between 200 to 600, a mere fraction of the British estimate, which ranges from 8,000 to 34,000. If the new figures are correct, they could have a tremendous impact on international opinion. Each of the union leaders asked for the precise basis of the calculation. Some more information was given. There had been regular body checks on the 100,000 people who've been evacuated. Other tests have been carried out on more than a million people. But the delegation left Moscow knowing there would need to be further international verification if these forecasts were to be believed in Britain.
Nicholas Jones. Finally to China. The birth of a baby daughter has made our Peking correspondent and his wife suddenly more aware of the peculiarities of a country in which a quarter of the world's population has been born and brought up. Here's a report from the proud parent, Mark Brick.
So, in the worst affected areas, the top half meter is being taken away and buried between town and remote parts of the Soviet Union. In the villages, workmen are clearing out the surface of the pavements and even removing asphalt from the roads. In a series of briefings for the British delegation, officials explained the steps that have been taken to meet the fears of the local population. When contamination was found on leaves of some trees in Kiev, all the leaves in the Soviet Union's third largest city were swept up last autumn and buried in special bags. It was hearing of measures like that which somehow seemed to throw doubt on the latest estimate for cancer deaths that are likely to arise from the accident. Anatoly Romanenko, director of...
Mm-hmm.